What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Mostly Wrong Opinions. My name is Devin. That is Fred Durst, and we have a new movie for you today. It is Encanto.
Coming to the world is the reject.
Many years ago, this candle blessed our family with a miracle. Our house, our casita.
We watched Luca, and it had like an Italian thing going on. This one's got him. It's not very specific, but a general like Latin American theme going on, and I dug that a lot, and I dug it a lot in Luca too,
and Moana.
Oh yeah, and Moana. I went into the film interested, but more interested in like what the film would look like. But as the film moved on, of course, as any Disney film, I got wrapped up in the story.
Yep, I get wrapped up in a story about family, about where this magic comes from for this family. Right. This beautiful magical candle that was given to them after a horrible thing that happened.
Right. Well, it's a family of immigrants, and so they left their homeland, which it's not clear exactly where, somewhere in Latin America, and they moved to a new spot. And after some sort of terrible tragedy, like you said, they were gifted a candle. From who, how, it doesn't matter. Disney wisely breezes on past, and they got the candle. We're moving on. And this candle seems to have given this one family Madrigal, gifts or powers that they get when they reach a certain age. Like a door to the house appears, they walk through it, and boom, they've got some sort of magical power.
And in that door that's in their house, it's a big ass room.
It's right. The door, like it's like more like a portal, and like you go into almost a new world. But of course, this film starts off with a little girl. She's come of age. She goes to her door, and nothing happens. She does not appear to have a gift. And we fast forward a couple years later, and she still has no gift, and she seems to be the black sheep of this family. And meanwhile, her family, they range from everything. One little boy can control animals, one woman has superpowers, another one is just annoyingly gorgeous, and you're just like and you're just like, oh my god, where Marble, she's just regular, she's just a regular person,
regular
and
person.
She's having a hard time coming together with her family, who feels so different from her, specifically her grandmother, without any gifts.
The little boy, actually, that can control animals, it was his day to get his powers and get his door. And that's where we found out, he can talk to animals. And which I should have seen from when he was hiding underneath the bed, and she gave him a little tiger. I'm like, this shit has something to do with animals, but I didn't see that at all. But, you know,
that's because you were wrapped up in the plot.
I was wrapped up in it.
Do you remember that thing that Spider-Man left on the floor? The plot?
Boy, this is going to be almost in every video now. Talk truth. This plot in this film is really good. It's in depth, man. Because before you know it, people are starting to lose their power. It is up to Marable to find out why,
and there's a lot of worry that I really like this too, and this might have been something that you got kind of like caught up in, because this happened around the same time as that little tiger thing. There's a lot of worry that no one else would have powers, right? That they may, and maybe Marable would be, or Marable would be the first of all the rest to not have powers. So there's a lot of, everyone's really anxious about whether this little boy will get any powers on this day, or whether there's just something wrong with Marable. And then when the little boy does get powers, they're just like, oh yeah, you're just a piece of shit. So yeah, you're unimportant, Marable. Great.
Yeah.
I don't know why you didn't get powers. I don't know why you're the black sheep, but we're cool. You're not. Deuces. I thought that was really funny.
Basically, but the thing is, there was already a cautionary tale of someone who is the black sheep in this this family. Bruno! No one talks to Bruno.
We don't talk about Bruno.
We don't talk about Bruno, yeah.
But, I had that song stuck in my head all week, so. We don't talk about Bruno,
no. We don't talk about Bruno. speaking of the songs, man, the songs in this was getting it, boy. There was a song in here where
Lin-Manuel, awesome.
Oh, he wrote it? He wrote the songs?
Yeah.
It's perfect. Mm-hmm,
you did.
Perfect.
Yeah. And you can hear it. It sounds like a little bit like In the Heights, a little bit of Hamilton in there. Mm-hmm. You can hear it.
One of my favorite ones when the chick who could hear everything and like the gossip one. Man, and then they were moving too. They were dancing. I was like,
they're dancing. Yeah,
they were. This film has got some spice to it, dog. This is one of the first Disney films that I can remember that has real good cultural spice when it comes to like dance. But when it comes to animation, the part about family, it reminded me of Coco.
Yeah, it did. It's very similar to Coco. And I like the way you talked about spice, because this movie did have spice. It was well seasoned, you know what I mean?
Exactly. Frozen.
the only thing about it that I can give it a knock on is the twist. I suppose I saw it immediately. And I guess it's not a big deal, because like I said, if one word or one thing can like destroy the film, you don't really have a plot, you don't have a story, you just have like an event that happens, right? So like I'm not gonna say anything. I kind of figured where the movie was gonna go, but it still hit really hard when it did at the end, and you're like, oh, I see where we are. It still hit really hard, so I'm like, great. Because, like I said, they put a lot of focus in character, and they put a lot of focus in plot. Because each member of the family, there's a lot of them. Mm-hmm. There's a whole song to introduce everybody and everyone's powers. And at first, I was like, oh my gosh, there's so many characters. I don't know if I can keep these straight. But they are actually very, very clear. And that was never an issue. I was like, oh, I know exactly who that is, and I know what her power is. Boom, boom, boom. And it was very clear. Very well structured, very well organized. I enjoyed it quite a bit.
What else I enjoyed about this film is this is a Latin American, Latin family, but it's very, like, their skin tones are different.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's dope, man. I don't know.
It is.
I just appreciate Disney, paying attention to certain things like that when it comes to their animation. But you brought up something before we started filming about where Disney is down a path when it comes to a certain aspect of their films. What is it?
Yeah, I was looking at this film and I was like, where's the villain? And and it kind of hit me. I'm like, you know what? I don't think I've seen a true villain in a Disney film in a really, really long time. Like you said, where's Jafar?
Yeah.
Where's Ursula? And what's interesting is you don't notice it until someone like points to it, right? Because I was trying to figure out, I was like, okay, so she's the protagonist, who's the antagonist? And I was like, I don't think there is one, right? There is just a problem that she needs to solve. Everyone seems to be losing their powers and the house is breaking up, and we don't know why. We don't know what's going on. And that mystery carries us through the film just fine without any need for an antagonist. Mm-hmm. So I think that's really interesting. I'm not sure why. This feels like a conscious effort on Disney's part to like not have a villain. So yeah. I'm not sure why. I'm not sure what that's about, but I think it's interesting, and I kind of like it, because if it kind of forces you to have a much deeper story, I think.
Yeah.
Rather than this guy good, that guy bad. You know, like it's a much more deeper, more soulful, as you say, seasoned story.
With Moana, it was the same thing. Their island was dying, and they needed to see why their crops and all their stuff was dying.
And I think this is a really good way, I think, to structure maybe some superhero films moving forward. You know, like I jokingly talked about Spider-Man, but you know what?
He's serious. All that joking stuff.
But I think it's a better candidate to have a non-villain movie, and that would be Superman, right? It's hard to challenge Superman anyway, right? Mm. So why wouldn't you have a movie where it's not Superman's body that's at stake? You're not worried if Superman's gonna get killed. You're worried about his soul, right? You're worried about his family. You're worried about something deeper. How come they don't ever do that? They always try to outpunch Superman, and that's so boring. And all you end up with is, Zack Snyder bullshit. So I feel like other companies or other properties could take note that there's other ways to tell really interesting stories and have really interesting characters without necessarily having to like punch everything or having a villain that you know symbolizes all the evil in the world or something. So I actually kind of really like this approach.
And I'm gonna go ahead and give my rating on this because I don't want to talk so much to where it's gonna spoil what the you see it from a mile away type of thing. You know, I don't want to.
Not that it matters because the movie still works just fine.
Yeah.
But yeah, of course you should discover this movie the same way I did. So I'm not gonna spoil it for you.
Yeah. So my rating for this film is an 8.
Yeah, great. I like this movie quite a bit too, and I'm gonna rate it higher than you. I'm gonna give it an 8.5. Actually really liked it. I had the music stuck in my head for a couple days.
Dancing, boy. Dancing, yeah, that's right. I was like, as soon as I saw them do that move together, I was like, oh, mm-hmm. I got up. I was like, okay.
That's really funny. That's really funny. Yeah, but I thought the music was great. I've had it stuck in my head. Lin-Manuel Miranda, whose name I always butcher. Yeah, for some reason my mouth just does not like it, but he's really good. Even though I think he is starting to hit like a cruising altitude though, because I'm starting to hear similar notes in like every song in every movie he's done, and I feel like I can spot one of his films like this. But it's a not necessarily negative just yet, because I still really enjoy the movie, and there's a lot of actors, especially like the main character played by Stephanie Beatrice, I believe that's how you pronounce her name. She was also in The Heights with Lin-Manuel Miranda. Mm-hmm. So clearly his experience here as just, I think it brings, it shows and it brings a lot to the story. And I really enjoyed it. I'm happy.
A good week of films.
Palate cleanser. Like,
oh. Like, yes. Yeah, thank you.
Exactly.
Thank you, Encanto. Yeah. And Don't Look Up. Oh.
Yeah. I tell you, sometimes me and you, we watch a lot of movies on this show, man. And some of these movies are trash. And I'm like,
oh, we didn't get a chance.
So much.
We didn't get a chance to do our worst movies or best movies of 2021 because I don't know. Maybe because a lot of them were really bad. So
I was thinking about that too. I was like, you know, I don't really care. I'm gonna parse through this trash. I don't know if I want.
Maybe by the end of this year, people, we will come up with a worst and best list and get that out to you guys. But
I'll be honest, Tyrone. If you force me to do it, I'll do it only because I made you hang up that thing in the back, the Mostly Wrong Opinions thing.
So it's very bright, people.
Is it? I didn't notice. Didn't even.
You
notice.
Can see it through. Mexico, I don't know.
From space.
Oh man. But hey,
who knows? Maybe that'll get people to like and subscribe. You never know.
You should. You better. You should. but everyone, that is our review for Encanto. Really enjoyed our talk here. We thank you again for clicking on this video, people. And just like Devin just said, you know, don't be blinded.
Don't be blinded by the light.
Don't be blinded by the light. Come to the light. Yeah. And
come, my child. Come
to Mostly Wrong Opinions. And subscribe, all right? And hit that notification bell right after you subscribe so you can be notified. No, notified.
No, notified or notified, whichever one.
Of every video that we post right here, almost.
Notified sounds like a medication or something. Yeah.
Side effects of notified include excessive.
Terrible opinions.
Terrible opinions. Excessive diarrhea.
Gas and bloating.
Gush. Inside joke, people. Inside joke.
This joke has been going on. And we've never explained it. So
man.
At this point, I don't think we ever will. But anyway.
Never will. But hey, people, if you want to hear some more gushy stuff, click that subscribe button, all right? But if you liked our review here, please, thumbs up. It really does help out the channel. Or you can thumb it down. You can be like, F you guys, man. You guys' opinion is sorry. Sucks.
Fucking love Spider-Man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Go ahead. It's your opinion to love Spider-Man. But just remember one thing. It is mostly wrong. See ya.
Gushy.